You know, it's been an interesting discussion this morning. Thank you, Madam President. It's been interesting discussion this morning, and it's actually been a little troubling to me to hear some of the things that have been said. First of all, I want to say that I think it's unfortunate when we start to bring racism into this discussion and we start to impugn the governor and some of the things that are happening. I think we need to be awfully careful. I think we need to be awfully careful about the words we use. What is this bill doing? It is simply allowing those individuals to decide for themselves if they want to pay union dues or not. That's it. We've heard a lot of passion this morning, and I can respect that. There's nothing wrong with that. But I'm here to say that there's a lot of passion out there from those who believe in right to work as well. I've heard from a number of people. I've heard from a lot of people out there who say, I'd love to be down there. I'd love to be able to share my voice, but I can't because I don't have anybody there to pay for me to come here. And I don't have any money because I'm unemployed. They want to have a voice, but they can't. So let me tell you loud and clear, the majority of Hoosiers are standing with us. They may not be the loudest, they may not be the most obnoxious at times, but they're there. And they're standing, and they'll be there when you go home. You know, I can live with people in my front yard carrying signs. If that's what they need to do, that's fine. I can live with people cussing at me when I walk out there, calling me names, impugning my character. That's fine. If that's what they need to do, I can live with that. But in the end of the day, I think it's time for everyone to take a step back and say, what are we doing here? And I'm telling you, we're giving freedom to those workers who don't want to be part of something they don't believe in. I heard the word union busting yet again today. And I've always been bothered by that as we started this discussion. If this is truly union busting, what does that say about our unions? If really the only way that our unions can avoid being busted is to force people who don't agree with them to pay dues to them, then maybe they should be busted. I don't believe that's the case. We've seen in other right-to-work states, unions haven't been busted. In fact, some of them have gotten stronger. Why? Because they've had to prove to their workers that they're worth being there. Isn't that the American way? I think so. I've heard that this is radical this morning. Radical? It's radical to try and find ways to create jobs. Well, if that's radical, I want to be radical, because that's what we're called to do, create more jobs for our great Hoosiers, especially those who aren't working right now, who can't find work. Radical? Finally, I've heard... Sad. Finally, I want to talk about the jobs.
Senator Long, one more outburst and we will ask for the gallery to be cleared. Please be respectful.
Finally, I want to talk about the jobs issue. I've heard people over and over again say, show me the jobs. You haven't brought up jobs. Well, I am happy today to say already, yesterday we received a call from Northeast Indiana from a business who was planning on relocating to a right-to-work state and expanding their business. Yesterday they informed us that they're going to stay in Indiana in anticipation of Indiana becoming a right-to-work state, and they're going to create 120 new jobs, they're going to provide more capital investment into the Northeast Indiana, and that means 120 more Northeastern jobs and workers are going to go back to work. I also received another email from an EDC individual who said, guess what? There's a company in Michigan who had written off Indiana from the start and refused to even consider them because they weren't a right-to-work state. In anticipation of Indiana becoming a right-to-work state, they've asked Indiana to participate in the bidding. Will we get them? I don't know. But at least we now have a chance to compete. And there's a lot of companies out there that will now allow Indiana a chance to compete. That's what we're here to do. Provide jobs and freedom. That's what this vote does. And I strongly urge you to stand up for all Hoosiers, all working people, and let's create jobs for them because they need them. And I ask for your support.
The bill is placed on its passage. The machine is open. Machine is closed. Clerk will tally the vote. The roll call shows 28 ayes, 22 nays. The bill is passed. Shall the title of the bill remain the Senator Yoder, shall the title of the bill remain the title of the act? Will you name the House sponsor? Senator Yoder, would you approach the podium? The House sponsors are. Got it. Secretary will inform the House of the passage. We do. One motion we must run. Clerk will read.
Madam President, I move that Senator Hirschman be added as co-sponsor of engrossed House Bill 1001. Senator Yoder.
Is there a discussion? Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion adopted. The Senate will stand in recess until fall of the gavel.